Welcome to Yoga Coaching. This is part 3 of Scrum Master interview question answers. You are going to learn few tips to answer for 7 real experience interview questions asked in the Scrum Master interview. Let us see the 7 questions which will be covered in this video. The first question is, what is the difference between the burn down chart and burn up chart? The second question is, what validations the team can do to ensure that the user story is complete and ready for the implementation? The third question is, do we need a manager role for this Scrum team? Explain the reason for your answer. The fourth question is, as a Scrum Master, how will you handle the situation if the product owner wants to add a new user story in the mid of the sprint? The fifth question is, can we use the velocity as the productivity metrics for the Scrum team? Explain the reason for your answer. The sixth question is, describe an impediment you faced in your team and how did you address that? The seventh question is, why should we do the refactoring during the development and explain the benefit of refactoring? Let me give you a few tips to answer for the first question, what is the difference between burn down chart and burn up charts? When you answer for this question, you should explain the purpose of burn down chart and burn up charts before explaining the differences. The purpose of using a burn down chart is to show the amount of work remaining in the sprint. Here the key point to note is, remaining work will be shown in the form of effort or story points. Burn down chart helps the team to predict the sprint goal completion based on the current progress. Burn up chart shows how much work has been completed and the total scope of the project. The advantages of using the burn up chart over the burn down chart is the inclusion of the work scope. Any scope added to the sprint goal can be tracked using the burn up chart. Burn down chart will give detailed information. Burn up chart will give high level information. Burn down chart will tell how much work is left. Burn up chart will tell how much work is done. Let me give few tips to answer for the second question. What validations the team can do to ensure that the user story is complete and ready for the implementation? User story can be considered as complete and ready for the implementation if it meets few conditions. User story should have the description. Acceptance criteria should be available for the user story. User story should be small in size so that can be delivered within the single sprint. User story should be testable. User story should be estimated in story point by the team members. User story should independent, negotiable, valuable, small and testable. These are the minimum expectations to qualify the user story that is ready for the planning and implementation. Let me give the tips to answer for the third question. Do we need a manager role for the Scrum team? Explain the reason for the answer. This is one of the important questions asked in the Scrum Master interview. Scrum framework recommends only 3 roles, that is Scrum Master, Product Owner and Development Team, and not mentioned any other roles. But in any organization, many activities related to people management should be done to enable the Scrum teams. The activities related to hiring, training, resource assignments to the team is needed for the Scrum team. To address the people related needs, there should be a person in the organization. So people manager role is needed for the Scrum teams, but it would be outside the scope of Scrum framework and the daily work deliverables of the Scrum teams. People manager role is needed to support the Scrum teams, to identify the new team members, move the people between teams, backfill the resources if there is any attrition, hiring people to form a new teams, etc. So you can highlight these points in your answer. Hope these points will be helpful for your interview preparation. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and click the bell icon to get notification about new videos. Now let's see few tips to answer for the question. As a Scrum Master, how will you handle the situation if the product owner wants to add a new user story in the mid of the sprint? This situation will occur in most of the Scrum teams. To handle this kind of situations, Scrum Master can do some activities by facilitating the meetings. Scrum Master can facilitate the discussion between the development team and the product owner to understand the priority of the new user story and why it's needed at the mid of the sprint. New user story can be replaced with some other user story in the backlog based on team's agreement. Accepting the change enables the agile way of working and bring the agile mindset within the team to support the customer needs. Scrum Master can coach the team to have the agile mindset as per the agile principles. If the team members are not willing to accept the new user story, Scrum Master can coach the team to bring the agile mindset within the team. You can highlight these points along with additional information based on your experience in the interview. Let us see a few tips to answer for the fifth question. Can we use the velocity as the productivity metrics for Scrum teams and explain the reason for your answer? This is another important question asked in the Scrum Master interview. Your knowledge on velocity and agile metrics will be assessed with this question. The answer for this question is no. That is, velocity is not the productivity metrics. You can explain the main purpose of having the velocity metrics in the Scrum team. That is, velocity should be used to forecast the timeline to complete the pending backlog items. So this will be used by the product owner to define the roadmap based on the backlog item. So velocity is not the productivity metrics that will be used by the development team. Now let us see the answer for the question. Describe an impediment you faced in your team and how did you address that? One of the main activities of a Scrum Master is removing the impediments in the team. You can highlight the impediments related to infrastructure issues, requirement change during the sprint, people related problems like attrition, unavailability, etc. Provide your answer in the STAR model. S for situation, you need to explain what is the actual situation. T for task, what was the expected task from your side. A for action, so what actions you have taken. And the result, R is for the result, that is the outcome of your action. For example, consider the requirement for a user story is changed during the sprint and team members are raising the impediment. As a Scrum Master, you can facilitate the discussion with the product owner and help the team to swap the new requirements with the different user story, or coach the product owner to wait for the next sprint so that this new user story will be taken in the sprint. You can give this kind of example in your answer related to impediments and how you resolved in your project. Now let us see a few tips to answer for the seventh question. Why should we do the refactoring during the development and explain the benefit of refactoring? You can highlight the purpose of doing refactoring and the benefits in your answer. The basic purpose of code refactoring is to make the code more efficient and maintainable. Refactoring improves the internal consistency of the software systems, whether it's a software code, structure, design, database, or an user interface. Refactoring enables you to evolve the code slowly over time to take an iterative incremental approach. Refactoring makes code more readable. Refactoring is done by the team to remove redundant, unused code. Refactoring will help to improve the performance of the product or the application. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Be sure to subscribe and click the bell icon to get notification about new videos. Thank you.